Goshen team is a team that was saved from Mandebu fire disaster. To those who were here last year for the champs, I'm sure you can recognize some of the faces that are up front. These guys, because of their faithfulness, God has added something up to their lives. Hands of Hope, which is led by the Church of Nazarene, has offered these four guys, Elton, Frederick, Elena, and Abigail, 14 hectares each to work on. This came up as a result of their faithfulness. You remember last year we went down to Mandebu to see what Elton has done on the ground to some of you who are here. So that's why they were given these 14 hectares. Unfortunately, the time they left Mandebu going to Goshen was very, very late. They left on the 1st of September and they managed to do almost 2 hectares each. They cleared it, camping it up, dug their holes and did all that was needed for them to do for land preparation. And all of them, they've managed to plant 1 hectare of maize. The other hectare, they've just planted sugar beans and groundnuts. And they are busy planting mukuna beans. Going to Goshen was not an easy job. The Heads of Hope have promised us that they could mend their houses, then they would let them in. But because of their curiosity, they said, no, we can move in even though there are no houses to live in. So they went there and they are still living in houses that you cannot say they are living. But because of their faithfulness and what God is leading them to, they are there in Goshen. These guys, when they went there, they were told that this soil is despised. You cannot get anything from this soil. And for sure, there are several people who were taken by the Hands of Hope, people to go and plow and do whatever they can, and they came out with nothing. And when they saw these guys clearing their land, digging their holes, they were saying, what are you doing? Do you think you can come out with something from this kind of soil? This soil is despised. It will never give you anything. But we thank God we have nothing, we have something that we can see for them. Can you show some pictures? So when they cleared their land, they managed to clear 1 hectare within 2 weeks. For us, it was amazing. Even for me right now, from today, even today, I'm just amazed how they made it to clear and dig walls in 2 weeks' time, being a mother and a father, because their children are going to school and they are still young. For me, this shows that the hand of God is upon these guys. God is taking them somewhere where no one's ears have heard, where no one's conscience have thought of, where no one's eyes have seen. This is where God is taking them. But this is only done through faithfulness. For me now, let me just hand over to the guys to speak for themselves what they have done since they left Mandebu.
Not in Makadini.
He's saying, how are you, everyone?
No, quite saying, Musita Rajesu.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus.
The Nekuti ndiwo watikuraramira pari zvino.
Because this is the one why we are living today.
Ndoda kupa kuchipo chekutenda kuna Mwari.
I have to give thanks to the Lord.
Nekuti ndiye akandidana kuti ndive ndiri mukati menzvimbo ino yandakatsika zuva ranhasi.
Because he is the one who called me to be in this place where I am today.
Ndakanga ndakarasika.
I was a lost sheep.
Ndararama murima.
I was living in darkness.
Zvandaiva ndiri ndichiuya mukati menzvimbo ino.
What I was before I came to this place.
Ndikazvirangarira ndinobuda misodzi.
If I think of it, I would be crying.
Nekuti ndinorangarira nguva yakarasika muupenyu hwangu.
Because I think of the time that I've lost during that time.
Asi Mwari vakandirangaridza.
But God reminded me.
Kuti ndivo vane ndangariro. Dziri ndangariro dzerugare.
He is the one who has got good thoughts about us.
Uyezve vanondipa mugumo unotarira.
And he gives me a good ending.
Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. Ndo zvainotaura.
This is what Jeremiah chapter 29 talks about verse 11.
Ndabuda mukati menzvimbo ino.
Coming out from this place.
Takaenda kunharaunda yatinogara.
We went to Mandevu where we used to stay.
Takasvika tikatovodza zvatanga takarayirwa kuno.
We went there and did what we have learnt at the training.
Zvakanga zvakaoma.
It was not easy.
Kutedzera CA.
To follow CA principles.
Zvinoti wadzii.
It's painful.
Asi zvine tariro yakanaka.
But there is a good hope in it.
Ndakakwanisa kurima mapfumbudza anokwana kuita 8.
He managed to plant about 8 pfumbudza plots.
Ndikakwanisa kuhwawo 83 bags.
He managed to get 83 by 50 kg bags of maize.
Mushure membavha dzauya dzikaba mumunda mangu.
After thieves have come and stolen in my field.
Zvakangondirwadza asi ndakaziva kuti Mwari vane chinangwa nazvo muupenyu hwangu.
It pained me at first, but at last I thought that God has something to do with me in future.
Zvadero takazowanirwa nyasha sekutaurwa kwazvangoitwa.
Then later on we got grace from God.
Takazonogara kuGoshen kwatiriko zvinozvi.
We went to Goshen where we are staying right now.
Zvakanga zvakaoma nguva yatakasvika zvakare muGoshen.
It was hard by the time that we reached Goshen.
Kutema miti.
Cutting down trees.
Kudya nzou.
Eating an elephant.
Kuchera makomba.
Digging holes.
Nemazuva anokwana 60.
In about 30 days, in about 60 days.
Zvakatitora kurwadza panguva iyoyo.
It was painful during that time.
Zvataiva tinazvo zvekudya zvakasvika pakutiperera.
The food that we had come to get finished.
Takamboita nguva yatakararama nemichero yemusango.
There's a time that we had to survive on wild foods.
Tichimbobvutidzana netsoko.
Fighting with the monkeys because that's their food as well.
Asanga tiri chiono nekudzidziswa naMwari mukati merwendo.
But that was a vision and a teaching that God was giving us.
Kuti hakuna chinomboya zviri nyore mukurara.
Meaning that nothing good comes easily, but you have to fight for it.
Takasangana nekushorwa zvakanyanya pane basa rataiita.
A lot of people look down upon us.
Tai taurirwa madimikira nekunongwa.
There were bad names that we were given.
Vamwe vaiti tiri matrakita.
And some people would call us tractors.
Vamwe vaiti timbai mufe.
Some would say dig and die.
Asi zvetaingosisa kuna Mwari.
But everything we laid it down to Jesus.
Mwari vaitizarurira panguva iyoyo.
God was revealing something to us that time.
Neshoko riri mukati meBhaibheri.
Through the word that is in the Bible.
Joel chapter 2 verse 23.
Joel chapter 2 verse 23.
Inoti.
It says,
Farai mufarisise imi vana veZion.
Be glad and be glad you children of Zion.
Nekuti ndinokuunzirai mudzidzisi wakakwanira.
Because I'm going to bring you a teacher who is enough for you.
Uchakunisira yumvura nomwedzi wokutanga.
Who will bring enough rains in the first month?
Nomwedzi wokutevera.
In the following month.
Amen.
Amen.
Ndinongoti zvakatisimbisa.
That strengthened us.
Taiti tichimuka rungwanani roga roga.
Every day we woke up in the early morning.
Takawanikwa tichiwanikwa tichiwa tinodivota mangwanani oga oga.
Every day we woke up, we devoted our time to God.
Taiungana tonamata tokumbira Mwari simba.
We gather together and start to pray before we go to our fields every day.
Taikumbira Mwari kuti vatipe hutano.
We were asking God to give us health.
Nasuno tinofara. Tine mufaro mukati memwoyo yedu.
Today we are happy. We have got happiness in our hearts.
Ndinotangaridza kuti Mwari kune vapa vari kutiendesa.
And it reminds us that God is taking us somewhere.
Vaya vaitiseka.
Those who were laughing at us.
Vakuya vachishanyira kuzoona zvirimwa zvenyu.
They are now coming to see what we have done on the ground.
Mvura yakanaya zvakanyanya gore rinori.
The rains have rained in excess.
Zvirimwa zvevamwe vose vakatikomberedza.
Most of the crops of our neighbors.
Zviri mumvura pari zvino zvino hakuna chiriko.
Are just in puddles of water and there's nothing that they are going to harvest.
Zvinotaridza ruoko rwaMwari kwatiri.
This shows the hand of the Lord upon us.
Ndinongopa kutenda Mwari naizvozvo.
I just want to thank God.
Mufaro wangu kwamuri mwari.
It's my pleasure to talk to you.
Ndinokutenda Mwari nekutsitsa pane pamberi pouso hwavo.
I just want to thank God for letting me come up front his face.
Tichitenda zvakare Mwari nekundisvitsa pane ino nzvimbo panguva yetraining.
And thanking God also for letting me be part of this conference.
Ndainge ndiri munhu aizvidzikisira aizvitarisira pasi ndisati ndauya patraining.
I was somebody who's looked down upon himself before I came to this training too. Foundations for Family Training.
Ndaizvitarisira pasi nekuti ndainge ndisina kudzidza, ndainge ndisina chikoro, ndakangoita grade 1 up to 7.
I looked down upon myself because I'm not educated, I just went up to grade 7.
Asi ndichisvika pano, madha konzi vakanditaurira kuti ndimi vanhu vatinoda vasina kudzidza kuti tikupei maskills ekuzvibatsira muupenyu.
But when I came here, Konsi myself, I told him that you are the guys whom we want. It's not about education, but it's about you. It's about.
So ndinoda kuisa mbiri kuna Mwari, ndinoda kuisa mbiri kuna Konsi nekuti ndingazo kumorovesa neshamo yaMwari nekuti mbiri ndakuipa kuna Mwari. Handidi kuti titukise madha nekuti Mozisi akazviita pananyomeri 20 pavhesi 10. Kuti akaita kuti mbiri iende kwaari akanzi naMwari hauchasvitsa vana vaIsraeri munyika. Saka ndoda kuti madha vatisvitse panofanira kusvika aiwazangu tini.
To give the glory to Konsi, but the glory should go back to Lord. Because if you remember Moses, he was given all the glory and he didn't manage to go with the children of Israel. So they want me to go with them to where God wants to take them.
So ndinongotendawo Mwari naizvozvo. Galatians chapter 2 verse 20 note, handichirini ndinorarama asi Jesu ndianorarama mandiri.
I just want to thank God for that reading, Galatians chapter 2 verse 20, which says it's no longer me who is living but Jesus Christ.
Amen. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20, you know it.
Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20 says
Ephesians chapter 2 verse 8 says takaponeswa nenyasha nekutenda izvo zvisingabvimatiri asi chipo chaMwari hachibviriwo mabasa kuti kurege kuva nemunhu anozvikudza.
I think we can read Galatians chapter 2. We are not saved by works, but we are saved by the grace of God. It's my pleasure to be speaking to you for my second time.
And Foundation for Farming. Ne basara ndai tanda kutisaidia kutokera kumba. Ndishi chino shikandishiwa neko na baba zewa mwana.
When I come here, when I came out from this training, went back home, I decided not to do what I used to do, but to get married. I talked to my husband that we should start doing something about farming. Well, I got married to this man because he was a drunkard and I also was a drunkard. So this time we have to change our moods and start doing God's way. When I go back, it's only me who stopped drinking, but my husband continued drinking. We also went and did our
plots.
They managed to get about 2 by 50 kgs of maize. As we were moving, we were called to Champs here. But my husband could not stop drinking beer. Coming back from the Champs conference, because the husband was still drinking and he couldn't fend for the family, so I thought it's better to leave him. Because of the one who was shepherding us, she reconciled us, Jack, into our marriage, and we continued living together. Yeah, I was just persevering through the pains. Yeah, that was life.
And she's over.
The grace of God was upon us, and we moved from Mandevu going to Goshen. When we arrived at Goshen,
I was in the Pakutanga Shakashaganaka.
At first, the things were okay.
Murumongo Pakashango Shikapanga Pasina.
There came a time whereby we had nothing on the table to put on the table.
Upon the Ganaga Shakura,
and I was pregnant.
Murumonga got one of the Boko at Winsor. In his house, Panach Kaf, Yoga Shakura, and up preparation. Saga, better to get as a double. Connected and she watched as she knew I would do.
My husband started saying, we better go back to Mandevu. You see, you brought me up here at Goshen, but things are not moving. No food. Look, we are pregnant. Like the Israelites when they said, Moses, can you take us back to Egypt? Where we used to eat man or whatever they used to get. Even myself, I also came to an extent whereby I was saying, for sure, let's go back. But Conciliar came and strengthened us again. Even going to the devotions, I have stopped doing that. When we go to Goshen, my husband stopped drinking. And when I said, I'm stopping going to the devotions, he said, you can stop, but myself, I'm going to the devotions.
So it daka chishanda chiri mumunda.
Working in the fields.
Semu nangaka zvitakura.
Like someone who is pregnant.
Sometimes ndaienda, sometimes ndangandisinga ende.
Sometimes I could go to the fields, sometimes I could not.
Saka murume wangu ndiye aishanda ende pari zvino ndiye atopa mberi nekuchechi.
My husband is a hard working man, he's the one who has done all the work that I've done, that we have done in the fields, and he is now ahead of me in church things. So she just wants to thank God by that. I also want to thank God for the I was hungry, baby. She also wants to thank God because they are now able to sit down and discuss about money map.
Foundation for family.
We can also sit down and resolve problems as a family through foundations for family. One is the one for those who were here last year. This is the one who was not around, but by the grace of God, we've got another one called Abigail Jarangwa. It's my pleasure to be up front here. For my first time to come to the Champs Conference. First of all, I'd like to thank God. I thank God for burning our houses at Mandevu. It was a way that God wanted to take us to Goshen. If those houses were not burnt, I'm sure we should not have been talking about Goshen. Because of time, I'm just going to talk much more about Goshen. We went to Goshen on the 1st of September. On the second day, I went with my husband to the field. When we got there, my husband said, have you ever seen a hectare being finished by hand using a hoe? He said using a draft power you need about 2 weeks to finish a hectare. Then I asked him, are you afraid of the job? Then he said, you can do it, let me see.
Every day in a 5-10 WhatsApp.
We went early in the morning to the fields every day, but when we go to the fields every day, you could start WhatsApping. I did almost 2.5 kumbuza, plus on my own watch he was watching me.
After that 3 days.
After those 3 days? I got him, he went first to the field and I found him working very hard. So when we started working together, we managed to finish a hectare, and he is now saying next year we need to do 2 hectares of maize.
That is,
thank you. You know, for all these good things to come out, it wasn't about me, it was about God. There are a lot of people who were working behind the cameras. For this group, I can give the time to Pastor Macheso, who have been working with them since 2016, because they came here 2015 for the training and they went back and we called them in December because there was chaos within the group. No one could know what a good church looks like. So I came here, I told my superiors that I think the reason why these guys are not doing well is because they are not rooted in a good church. So the top management managed to invite a good pastor who would tell them what a good church looks like. And when they went back after that, that's when we started to see fruits. So I just want to say thank you so much, Pastor Macheso, for being used by God to raise these guys. Yeah. It's not about me.
Well, it is my privilege to be before you this good day. I would like to thank God very much for the good work that He has started through Foundations for Farming. Because according to my perspective, when there was that fire disaster in our community, most of the people were very much hopeless. And because of that disaster, there came so many people that were assisting people. Some came with clothes, some came with food. Even our church, through a certain missionary organization, gave them shelter. But I just want to thank God very much for the permanent thing that He did to most of the people that were victims of that fire disaster through Fame Foundation for Farming, because when those people were hopeless, there were no food and forth tower. The foundation came and took almost 30 people and housed them here and gave them food, not only physical food, but also spiritual food. The team that came here were very much enriched. The community encompasses about 5,000 people, and people are highly populated there. It's a small farm, but it encompasses about 5,000 people. And of those 5,000 people, just like one who testified about Epway, the main curriculum and main activities there is prostitution and theft. So even as you have heard some of them testifying here, I thank God very much for the good work Foundation for Farming did. Because of all the people that came here, they received Christ. They were introduced to Christ. And some of them, they still have that conviction, and right now I'm still working with them, so that they may continue to be nurtured in the way God wants them to be nurtured.
Amen.
Much more, I humble myself for the servant of God who is here with me, Quincy. And I thank God yesterday when I heard a testimony from Craig saying that when these guys were coming here, He did not promise them that they will find a road here, but they said, I want to work with people that doesn't know any road, and through you guys will create a road. And I thank God for her very much. She faced so many challenges when she was coming to our community. But I thank God that He connected myself to Konse and also to Audition for Farming. Since then, I humble myself before her because she had done what the church should have done, or Fame Foundation had done what the church should have done to reach for the unreached. But I just thank God very much for giving me the privilege to work and partner or coordinate with Foundation for Farming. If I need to testify about the life of my brother Frederick, who's here, he was a dreadlocked man, a drug addict, living on drugs. But when he came here and came back to the community, he was a changed man. I never knew this man personally. I never. But because of God, we met. He testified to the church that everything was burnt, including the marijuana that I used to sell. I tried to look for a help for my brother, and my brother said, I cannot help you anyway except giving you again marijuana so that you can continue to sell it. But because he had received Christ when he came here, he said, if it is marijuana, brother, go away with your gift. Elena, as she has testified here, she was someone who could raise and leave, going from one bar to another, drinking and doing all sorts of prostitution, should I mention it? But when she came here, Fame Foundation for Farming, they did not teach them only the skills to do farming, but they also introduced her to Jesus.
Amen.
And when she came back to the community, she was a changed person. We knew her because here and there she used to come to church, but when she came here and came back to church, she was totally a different person. Abigail as well. She used to go to the white coming sect. You know, we call them the apostle sects in here in Zimbabwe. She's a prayer warrior, Terry. God works in a way we can never understand.
Amen.
Even Brother Elton, traditionally, you know, the people have the norms that are only old people can use, better use. Because they think that in the African tradition, those people have got some juju they call divisi that works for them to produce higher youth. But when Elton came here and came back home there, he did all he could do, working hard through the techniques and the training that he received here. He had a bumper harvest that all the people in the community came to realize that tradition is but nothing, but what God inspires into people. Through Elton, they learned a lot. Until today, our church has managed to grow. There's a number that amounts about 20 to 25 people that came because of the testimony these guys gave. We introduced these guys to our Bible study that we do at our church, trying to nurture them the way God wants it. And also, I would like to continue thanking our sister Quincy here. She used to visit them and encourage together, we encourage them that, guys, God has a purpose for you. Do not be weary, for in due season you shall reap. And as we continue to pray and nurture them in the word of God, giving them memory verses, just as you have heard Brother Frederick trying to memorize the verses that we are teaching them at church, we prayed and prayed until God blessed them so much by the 14 hectares given to them now in Beatrice. I was so much afraid by the time they left our community because it was already late. I engaged the church to pray for them on a daily basis. That was not enough for us. But later on, we relied on God's guidance and provision. And really, they worked hard. And while they are today, last month, together with the church elders, I visited Goshen. What I saw there was a great hand of God upon them. They testify that all the people around, because of so much rain this year, there is nothing in other people's fields. But as I looked into their field, it was a great, amazing thing that I saw there. God worked through them. And I would like to thank you very much. I myself also would like to thank Sister Quincy because She taught these people to apply one biblical verse that is of paramount importance. When Paul was talking to Timothy, that my son Timothy, the thing that you have heard me speak before many witnesses, entrusted to a trustworthy men that are faithful, so that they can go and give all that I've shared with them to others also. These people here, they've shared what they learned at Firm Foundation for Family to other people that are in the community and also some of our church members. I pray that within the few years to come, our community will be a great basket for some of the widows in the church and the community and also orphans. Because now FAME, Foundation for Farming, is all over our community. And when they went to Goshen as well, regardless of the little time that they had, they did not only work in their fields and for their lives, they continued teaching others that he had done exceedingly well, overcoming them as well. I would like to thank God for this and thank you very much in Jesus' name.